Breaking: Obama just hijacked White House website and sent huge FU to Trump with change he made. Michelle Obama summed it up perfectly back in 2009 when she stated during an interview that we must simply rewrite our America's history, as she made it no secret how much she and her husband hated our country. After a shameful 8 years of presidency overshadowed with embarrassing scandals, Barack Obama is now taking his wife's words to heart, as he's literally rewriting our nation's history in order to secure his legacy, in an outrageous move that will make you sick. Hitler's infamous Nazi propagandist Paul Joseph Goebbels knew all too well the value of a lie. "If you repeat a lie often enough, it becomes the truth," Goebbels famously stated. Obama knows this tactic all too well, as shortly after leaving the White House he made the unbelievable proclamation that his presidency was scandal-free, completely ignoring Benghazi, fast and furious IRS targeting of conservatives, his massive unconstitutional surveillance on Americans, and the handling of Hillary's email scandal, just to name a few. If there's one thing Obama is talented at other than being a pathological liar, it's his uncanny ability to hijack any conversation or scenario and make it all about him. This was evidenced most recently during Obama's farewell speech before Trump took office, where Obama man managed to mention himself a whopping 75 times within a short 51-minute speech, where he endlessly bragged about his legacy and accomplishments. While we've all gotten used to Obama's massive whoppers over the years, with his recent attempt to try and convince America his presidency was scandal-free, now Obama has taken his antics to a whole new level. He's now literally rewriting history, by making ridiculous changes to the White House's official website in order to brag about himself. Each president on whitehouse.gov has a public biography that's similar to a Wikipedia page, where Americans can learn all about what a specific American did during his tenure. But Obama has now hijacked these presidents' public profiles, where he's inserted long-winded bullet statements about his wonderful accomplishments as America's 44th president. Here's several screenshots of where Obama has included fascinating tidbits about himself on other presidents' profiles. Did you know? Bullets about Obama can now be seen on the public presidential profiles of 12 presidents, including Bill Clinton, George W. Bush, George H.W. Bush, Jimmy Carter, Richard Nixon, Lyndon Johnson, John F. Kennedy, Harry S. Truman, Calvin Coolidge, Franklin D. Roosevelt, Herbert Hoover, and most disgustingly, our most beloved president, Ronald Reagan. Below is the full text where Obama has interjected himself as a desperate attempt to make himself relevant, where he's literally rewritten history in a disgusting attempt to whitewash his shameful legacy. Here's what you can see on each president's profile now. William J. Clinton. Continuing his work as a lifelong public service, Clinton created the Clinton Foundation in 2001 to improve global health, education, economies and environments. Affectionately calling him do-gooder-in-chief, President Obama has worked with Clinton to make buildings in our country more efficient, announcing a $4 billion investment in energy efficiency upgrades for commercial buildings. In 2009, former President Clinton partnered with 43rd President Bush to help rebuild Haiti, after the country was devastated by an earthquake. George W. Bush. In 2002, President George W. Bush's State of the Union was the first to be live broadcast on the Internet. In 2011 and 2012, President Obama's State of the Union speeches were available in an enhanced live stream version that featured infographics, charts and data side by side in real time with the president's speech. George H.W. Bush. President Barack Obama awarded George H.W. Bush the 2010 Presidential Medal of Freedom, the nation's highest civilian honor, for his commitment to service and ability to inspire volunteerism throughout the country, encouraging citizens to be 1,000 points of light. The administration continues to promote service and civic engagement, honoring heroes of local communities as champions of change and fostering civic participation. Ronald Reagan. Obama even took over Ronald Reagan's space on whitehouse.gov to talk about himself. President Reagan designated Martin Luther King Jr. Day a national holiday. Today the Obama administration honors this tradition, with the first and second families participating in service projects on this day. In a June 28, 1985 speech, Reagan called for a fairer tax code, one where a multimillionaire did not have a lower tax rate than his secretary. Today, President Obama is calling for the same with the Buffett rule. Jimmy Carter. In 1977, President Jimmy Carter created the Department of Energy. Today, the DOE works with the Obama administration to drive towards innovation in energy and reducing reliance on foreign oil with an all-of-the-above approach. Richard Nixon. In 1973, Richard Nixon created the President's Export Council, which was expanded and reconstituted under President Jimmy Carter in 1979. Today, the BEC continues to work towards reaching President Obama's goal of doubling the nation's exports by 2014's end. Lyndon Johnson. President Lyndon Johnson signed Medicare law in 1965, providing millions of elderly healthcare stability. President Obama's historic healthcare reform law, the Affordable Care Act, strengthens Medicare, offers eligible seniors a range of preventive services with no cost sharing, and provides discounts on drugs when in the coverage gap known as the donut hole. John F. Kennedy. President John F. Kennedy famously suggested the American people, "Ask what you can do for your country." In 1961, the Peace Corps was created, facilitating service among citizens working toward peace in developing countries. In 2011, President Obama celebrated the 50th anniversary of the Peace Corps with a presidential proclamation. Harry S. Truman. In a 1946 letter to the National Urban League, President Truman wrote that the government has an obligation to see that the civil rights of every citizen are fully and equally protected. He ended racial segregation in civil service and the armed forces in 1948. Today, the Obama administration continues to strive toward upholding the civil rights of its citizens, repealing Don't Ask, Don't Tell, allowing people of all sexual orientations to serve openly in our armed forces. Source: Harry S. Truman Library and Museum. Franklin D. Roosevelt. On August 14, 1935, President Roosevelt signed the Social Security Act. Today, the Obama administration continues to protect seniors and ensure Social Security will be there for future generations. Calvin Coolidge. On February 22, 1924, Calvin Coolidge became the first president to make a public radio address to the American people. President Coolidge later helped create the Federal Radio Commission, which has now evolved to become the Federal Communications Commission, FCC. President Obama became the first president to hold virtual gatherings and town halls using Twitter, Facebook, Google+, LinkedIn, etc. Herbert Hoover. President Herbert Hoover signed the bill founding the Department of Veterans Affairs July 21, 1930. President Obama is committed to making sure that the VA, the second largest cabinet department, serves the needs of all veterans and provides a seamless transition from active duty to civilian life, and has directed his administration to modernize the way healthcare is delivered and benefits are administered for our nation's veterans. First Lady Michelle Obama and Dr. Jill Biden launched Joining Forces to mobilize all sectors of society to give our service members and their families the opportunities and support they have earned. This guy can't be freaking serious. It's truly startling how desperate this man is to retain relevancy in this country. What a tool, what a tool.